Hello everyone, I've had a lot of questions about how to render Mandelbrot videos, so I thought I'd put together this quick tutorial. Firstly, you're going to need to download Kalles Fraktaler and the Keyframes Movie Maker, and perhaps the gallery if you want those, and download the 64-bit versions for your computer. Secondly, so you can render directly to MP4, you need to download the K-Lite codec pack, and that is the mega version. Only the mega version has the export codecs that you need to render directly to MP4. Okay, what we're going to do is open a file. These files are from the gallery that comes with Kalles Fraktaler. So I'll open Golden Spider and just take a moment to allow that to render. It's currently set only to a low resolution, which allows it to render quickly, which is the best way to find your images. The first thing we need to do is set the image size to 4K, so that is 3840 pixels wide. So it's taken about a minute 16, but the 4K image has rendered. Next, we change the zoom size to 2. Then from the file menu, choose Store Zoom Out Images. Create a new folder to store the zoomed out images. The next question you'll be asked is about the JPEG properties. I usually drop the quality to about 95. Choose the same folder to store the images. You don't need to save the JPEG images, but they're very useful to check that your rendering is working correctly and for screenshots later. And now we wait. Once the rendering gets underway, it's handy to check a couple of JPEG images to see if the video is rendering correctly. Now that we've exported the keyframes, we need to join them together using the Keyframe Movie Maker. Firstly, choose the folder we exported to earlier. Next, I'm going to change the frame rate to 60 frames per second and adjust the speed accordingly. Because we're going to export directly to MP4, it's important that frames per movie is set to a large enough value to hold the entire video. Click Stop Movie directly on last frame, and I like to remove the zoom text. I'll make sure Alpha is unchecked and then click Start. Now we need to choose a codec. The best codec is the X264 codec. Click Configure. The first option is the speed. It is a trade-off between file size and the speed of encoding. It does not affect the quality. You should set the profile to high. The rate factor determines the quality of the video. 20 makes for a high quality video. This setting is great if you want to edit the video, but YouTube won't display anything near this quality. Now the most important bit, set the output mode to file, and then choose a location where you want to save the MP4 file. This is where your video will be saved. It will completely bypass the AVI files that are produced by the Keyframe Movie Maker. Click OK to begin the render. You can check the preview to make sure it's going to render correctly. And now the render is complete. Check out part of the video.